address for the weather today. A couple months ago, I attended a meeting about a block from here. One of the messages I took out of that meeting with some very capable government officials was that if the first time you're exchanging business cards and contact information in the middle of a crisis, you have failed in your crisis preparations. And council legislators in Metropolitan Chicago started its modern iteration in 1984 as a result of one of those failures. For those of you who are old enough to remember the glory days of the early 1980s in this great city, we had a surprise, Harold Washington got elected, which can send even a shock to a number of individuals in this city. And it led to some very exciting and colorful exchanges of views with city council, neighborhoods, and religious congregations across the community. And some of them were rather ugly. They reopened or made explicit the simmering racial hatred and distrust and ignorance that has been part of our city for at least the entire 20th century and well into this century. And religious leaders of that time, led by Cardinal Bernini, Father Solomon, Bishop Gakos, the Greek Orthodox tradition, and many other outstanding leaders, Episcopal dioceses, all various different figures, said, we should do something. We should speak out. We should not remain in our silos. We should remember we're part of a community. And so they did. They came together so that they would know each other, so that they could communicate in moments of crisis, so they could spread good teaching in their congregations, so they could open their buildings for conversations that their congregants needed to have among themselves and with their neighbors. And since that time, we've tried to do that. And we've tried to extend that ethos and to not live in our silos. Goodness knows we all have lots of work to do in our own communities to build, to tend, to care, to bring into the world, and to bury. It's all important. It consumes almost all of our time. But we cannot simply be for ourselves. We have to be for the other people. We cannot live in a silo. We are part of a community. We are neighbors. And so, when neighbors need help, we reach out. When neighbors are attacked, we defend. When ideas are disparaged, we protect. Where there is ignorance, we try to bring teaching and understanding. Where there is discord, we try to create an opportunity for conversation. Where people are divided, we look for common ground. Council legislators in Metropolitan Chicago at a leadership level tries to do that among its leaders so that they know each other and can talk frankly about their fundamental disagreements. There are things on that council that people will never agree to, and that's okay, because we live in a diverse society. What isn't okay is slaughtering each other, and disparaging each other, and ridiculing each other over those differences. And through action and through discussion, the council tries to model the way we live as humans in this diverse, faithful place. I'll close with one example, a recent issue that we are in the midst of. Our city is crippled, particularly in key neighborhoods, by indiscriminate, wanton gun violence. It slays everyone, and it slays them seemingly everywhere. Our community is not unique. This is a national plague, distinct to the United States. But we live here, so we decided to work here to help move things forward. And so, we're convening in the coming months conversations in congregations with anyone who agrees to of our community believe in the sacred value of human life. And every tradition at the council and every tradition in this city believes that. And number two, are you sick and tired of burying the innocent after their violence? Every tradition I know is sick. Every person I know is sick. Good. If you believe those two things, join us in our congregation and we'll talk about ways to get to reducing those two. Magnifying one, creating human life, sanctifying. And number two, preventing the senseless ending of it through human violence. No preconditions. I'm telling you the right answer. Let's figure it out together. What's your answer and how do you get there? That's an example of what we're trying to do. We have other programs that can detail them for you. But I'll close with this. And I'm honored to be in this room. There's so many different expressions of community across the difference, of people working outside of their silos. That's a sign that we're on the right path. There's lots of different expressions, lots of different ways for it to play out. But it's that cooperation, it's that respect, it's that commitment to common ground, and to being neighbors, the council is going to, and of which we are obviously.